I'm going to talk about the Zoom H1N and why it's become my go-to tool for audio for my videos. You're listening to it right now, straight out of these mics, and I haven't edited the audio at all. So the Zoom H1N is an audio recorder, which means it records the audio onto an SD card. This means it's more portable because it doesn't need to be tied to a camera. It also has better quality audio because cameras compress the sound they take in from a mic. But audio recorders are built specifically to store sound at high quality. Let's talk about the stereo mic that is built into the H1N. The two silver mics at the top of the H1N combine so that the left and the right can be recorded at the same time. So what does this mean in terms of the sound that it records? Stereo mics like this have a very wide reach, meaning it's trying to record sound from as many directions as possible. The H1N stereo mic is good for voice when you can bring the mic close to the person, sound effects when they're also close, sounds coming from many places like orchestras and bands, and atmospheric sounds at any distance. Stereo sounds a lot like what we actually hear with our ears, which also makes this mic really good for ASMR. The mic is not so good when there's background noise, like if you're outside or in a crowded space, when voices are more than a couple feet away, and when you're not careful about breathing into or holding the mic. If you want to point the mic at something from a few feet away and have it only hear that and nothing else, then you probably want a shotgun mic and not a stereo mic like the one built into the H1N. When you're looking at the description of a mic or recorder, you might see words like cardioid or omnidirectional or something like that. This describes how many directions the mic picks up sound from. Narrow being only listening from one direction, and wide being like surround sound in 3D. In these pictures, we're looking at the mic from above and it's pointed forward. The highlighted shapes are which directions the mic records audio from, basically which way it's listening. If you see the word omnidirectional, that means it's trying to record a bunch of different directions of sound. If you see the word supercardioid, that means it's narrowly focusing in on one sound. The Zoom H1N's mic is somewhere in between those two extremes. It's called a cardioid or unidirectional mic because it mostly blocks out sound from behind it, but it listens to a pretty wide area in the front. The H1N has a 90-degree span of where it picks up most of its audio. So if you want to get more focused audio, you can plug a shotgun mic like the Rode Video Micro into the Zoom H1N. It's important to think about these things when you're investing in audio because you want to get the type of microphone that's right for the situation that you're filming in. Let's test out the Zoom H1N, starting with how it sounds at different distances. Right now, my mouth is about 6 inches away from the mic. Now I'm about a foot away, 2 feet away, and now I'm about 3 feet away. As you can hear, the quality gets a lot worse the further back I moved. But if you have the ability to bring the mic close to your subject or to the sound that you want to record, it sounds really good. Just using any external mic is already going to be a huge step up in quality from your in-camera microphone. This is what the audio sounds like straight out of my camera. This is audio from the microphone in my earbuds connected to my phone. Now I'm using the Rode Video Micro plugged into the Zoom H1N. And this is the audio from the Zoom H1N's built-in microphone. Let's test out some of the features. One thing I really like is the wheel that controls the input audio level or the gain. Changing this makes your audio louder or quieter. You generally want your input level to be in between negative 12 and negative 6 decibels. The scale on the screen shows you that. There's an auto level feature that adjusts the gain for you, but I don't really use it. You can monitor your audio in real time or listen to your recordings later by plugging in headphones. And the H1N also has a speaker for playback. For the recording settings, you have a bunch of different options. You can record either .wave or .mp3 files. MP3 is more compressed, so the quality isn't as good, but the file size is also smaller. I use Wave because it's the least compressed and highest quality audio. Sampling rate is kind of like a frame rate, but for audio. The higher it is, the more space it takes up. 48 kHz, that's the standard for audio in videos. Bit depth is kind of like video resolution. The higher it is, the more detail there's going to be in the audio. So I use the highest setting, 24-bit. The H1N only works with SD cards up to 32 GB, which is about 30 hours of audio at the high quality settings that I use, so I don't have a problem with that. It has helpful effects like a low-cut filter which removes low frequencies like unwanted pops, clothing sounds, or air. The limiter allows you to record really loud sounds without it completely breaking down. It has an auto-record feature, so it starts recording whenever you talk. It can record audio 2 seconds before you start so that you don't miss the beginning of your audio. You can also add markers while you're recording or while you're playing back audio. Another feature is overdubbing. where you can listen to a file you've recorded and record a new one over it at the same time that creates a new file and keeps the old one. This is really useful for recording different parts of a song. You can also lock the buttons to prevent accidentally touching them during recording. This is useful for plugging a mic into the H1N and then putting it in someone's pocket, but this won't lock the audio level wheel. But you can put some tape over that to be sure. So those are some of the features of the H1N. Putting those into practice, I've talked about recording voice, but I also love to use this tool to make my own sound effects. And that's what I've done for you. Every Friday, I'm sharing something free with you that I've created or found as a part of my series called Freebeat Friday. Today, you get my free sound effect pack that I've created using the H1N that has two parts, air and water. You get whooshes, splashes, rain, atmosphere, and more. I was inspired by my favorite show, Avatar The Last Airbender, when creating the sound effects, so there will be earth and fire-related sound effects coming at a later date to complete all four elements. It really inspired me to create high-quality sounds that will really help your videos become more immersive. So some general pros and cons I have about the H1N. I enjoy the quality of the sound, and I like how easy to use it is. I like how easy it is to carry around and just record audio, or mount it on a tripod. The build quality I'm unsure about. It's made of plastic that feels pretty cheap, so I'm being careful not to drop it. One thing I don't like is that the AAA batteries in it seem to run out relatively quickly. I've been using this mic for over a month, and the batteries that came with the mic just ran out after recording about 8 hours of audio. Another con is that you can't bring the markers into your editing software unless you have something like Adobe Audition, which can read markers that are stored in WAV files. I hope this was helpful if you're considering buying this recorder, or if you're just looking to get into audio in general. Hope you enjoy the sound effect pack, and thank you for watching.